somebody who is also a prominent figure has sort of been dragged into the fray. I don't know if you guys noticed, but over the last couple of weeks, Naomi Campbell, supermodel extraordinaire, has been catching heat because she was associated with Maxwell and Epstein, and a few women came forward publicly to say that she knew back in the 90s at fashion shows that they were being abused. And no one really knows whether her brand was used by Epstein and Maxwell to attract young girls, and if it was something that she didn't know about, that they were sort of using her brand, like, because she's a supermodel and that's something that a lot of young girls aspire to, or whether she was sort of a conscious player in the situation. And I talked to my mom about this, and my mom got super defensive because she was like she was Miss Nigeria, and she met Naomi Campbell during that time. And she's always had this, even though Naomi Campbell's like a horrible bitch, my mom's also a bit of a like horrible, like she's cut from the same cloth, let's say. They're very similar. Like, my mom definitely has yelled at British Airways staff and thrown her phone at people, and you know, but yeah, anyway, yeah, so she got very defensive about it because in her mind she saw them as trying to off the black girl. That was the way my mom saw it, was that they were going to sort of create media hype and attention around Naomi Campbell in order to sort of distract from Maxwell. And I mean, I don't necessarily agree with my mom's analysis, but I can see her point, because
people that don't have a incredibly substantial institutional backing, someone like Naomi Campbell is a very like obvious example of someone that could potentially be. I'm certainly, you know, not going to put the name, like, any words in people's mouths, but he had like 20 numbers for Naomi Campbell in his black book.
Yeah.
He has a substantial amount of numbers for people that he has very good contact with for, you know, business and personal reasons. So I don't know why he would want to have that many numbers for her if he wasn't engaged with her in some kind of capacity. And in what kind of capacity he would be engaged with Naomi Campbell, it's kind of quite obvious.
I think that it was clout, because Naomi Campbell was she's already kind of notorious, so she's like an easy target in that regard. She had that scandal a few years ago with the blood diamond situation where she
didn't she throw her cell phone at her maid's head?
Yeah, she did. She also had to do like community service because she got into a bust up on British Airways with like the staff, and like was insulting them. She's always been known to have a bad, terrible temper. I don't know if you saw her like knock off America's Next Top Model TV show where she would just like psychologically abuse the girls. Like Tyra Banks, like, she psychologically abused the girls, but in this sort of like neoliberal way, whereas
way.
Like, in this neoliberal fun. Sort of fun, yeah, whereas Naomi was just straight up like Hitler to them. One of them would like laugh and she'd be like, what the fuck are you laughing at, you little fucking bitch? And it's just like, whoa, what the fuck.
But so yeah, she was basically like Tyra when she had her meltdown, but all the time.
But yeah, Naomi basically, because I think, back to the original point, I think it was clout related, because I feel like she probably felt like she needed to do a little extra because she was one of the only black supermodels at the time. In the 90s, I mean, there were only two models who were more higher paid than her, and that was, I think, Cindy Crawford and somebody else. I forget the name of the model, but she was like the third highest paid runway model at the time. But I feel like she felt she needed to ingratiate herself with members of the elite in order to maintain her popularity and her position, because it was precarious. Like, even though the supermodels are largely disposable, once your career time runs out, which is short, you have to either marry well or get yourself into another line of business in order to secure your fame and fortune. And I'm only speculating, she could have very well been awful, but we don't know the full story yet, which is why I'm like sort of reserving my judgment on her for now until more information comes out. But she did release a statement to say that she didn't know what was going on and that she's horrified and that she stands with the victims and this and that. But we'll just have to wait and see what happens as information comes up. But yeah, I think part of it was her trying to ingratiate herself with these elite circles for credibility and to and to sort of maintain her position. But then again, if you lay down with dogs, you get fleas. Like, if you try to do shit for clout, like, you know.
I don't think it was for clout. I think it was for money. I think, like, you know, the highest paid runway in one model is one thing. The kinds of people and the kinds of wealth that she was exposed to being around those people is of an entirely different level. And I think that she's probably just paid. Like, it's probably just money. No, like, maybe. You know.
I mean, you do kind of have to think about the kind of personality she would have to be able to make it through that already cutthroat business. But way back then, when black models were treated like garbage, and she would have had to have the kind of personality that, like, some CEO would have,
ruthless,
like a shark
on some level.
That's why she is how she is.
I mean, even the whole feud she had with Tyra Banks was basically because they were like, there was the whole attitude of there can only be one. And at the time, she was a little bit older.
I fucking love that. The fucking representation wars.
Yeah,
there can only be one. Or there can be only one.
At the time, Tyra was 16 and she had just gotten to Paris. And she was jealous of Tyra because Tyra was walking in fucking Chanel runways when she was like fucking 16. And they were like, oh, a new girl has come along. She's going to replace you. And also Tyra's mom was smart. Yeah, but also Tyra's mom.
Challenger has arrived.
Tyra's mom. Tyra's mom was also smart enough to actually go with Tyra to Paris so that she wouldn't get molested. And I think Naomi sort of felt resentful because she didn't have the same sort of protection. Fuck knows what Naomi actually went through in the industry at the time. And that's not a defense of her at all. Like, but usually people who are abusers have themselves been abused. And it just perpetuates this horrible cycle because that's how it is in these elite circles. It's a cycle of abuse, secrecy, and pain. But like I said, all of this is just speculation based on the information that I know and like what I'm deducing from it. But fuck knows, which is the reason why I'm not going to be quick to condemn her, especially because I have a feeling maybe Jazane will name her and she'll become the scapegoat while Jazane, the person who actually was doing the raping, gets away scot-free, which is, you know, how it usually is.
I think there could be an amount of blaming dead people as well. Like, there's probably a number of these people.
That's what I said last week. I think it's dead people that are really going to get it.
Because there was... I mean, and there's been a proven link between Savile and a lot of the MPs in Parliament throughout the 80s and 90s, and probably fucking today, like, who the fuck knows, you know, that were involved in his UK fucking shit, and that he was also, like, you know, a part of this kind of thing as well. I've seen, like, ways that he's been linked with, maybe not Epstein, but, like, if you knock over, like, because once you knocked over Savile, they, like, covered up all of the stuff that was associated with the Lords and, like, the MPs and any of the royals that might have been involved in that as well. Theresa May was actually the MP that managed to conveniently lose all of those files so that we'll never, ever know, really. Unless anyone actually, yeah.
Pretty much. Hey,
oh, it's in the
what does this button do? I don't know. What does delete mean?
Delete.
I don't know Spanish. I'm sorry.
Maybe it could be like a domino thing that we don't even know about with Naomi Campbell. Like, because she's kind of a wild card personality by the sounds of things, right? So if Ghislaine was going to come and, like, get Naomi's name through the shit and do stuff like that, I don't really understand what would completely restrain her from just being like, well, fuck all y'all then, and I'm gonna name the fucking names for real, not just whoever fucking Max, you know, fucking Maxwell decides is gonna be guilty or not.
Wild card,
I mean,
bitches.
I'll be,
this might be a dumb thought, but if Trump is in full control of the FBI and the CIA and everything, would they not be able to get Ghislaine to possibly implicate all these Democrats and essentially...
That's what I'm,
like,
afraid of.
Destroy.
That's the thing that I'm...
If they wanted a way to ensure that he was elected a second time, trying to paint the Democrats as these perverse... like, because There are a lot.
I was just going to say, like, it's not really that hard to paint them that way.
I suppose, yeah.
Uncle Touchy Touchy Joe Biden.
Yeah.
Bad touch uncle.
Come on, man.